Welcome back!
Be here? Have you ever heard the phrase, you are what you eat? Figuratively speaking, it means that if you eat healthy food, you are more likely to be healthy. But the phrase is also literally true. Remember last time when we learned that all living things are made of atoms? Well, the atoms that make up our bodies come from the food we eat and drink. But if I am what I eat, why don't I look like apples, carrots, and granola bars? I don't look like the food I eat, and I'm guessing you don't either, so what's going on here? We need some more chemistry to figure it out. By the end of this lesson, you'll be able to define molecules, explain what happens in a chemical reaction, and describe how chemical reactions are related to energy. Remember this? I hope so, because we'll have to periodically refer to it throughout the course. This is the periodic table, and it lists all of the known elements in order by number of protons in their atoms. For example, since this atom has 6 protons in its nucleus, shown as red in this model, we know it's an atom of carbon. From now on, instead of showing all of the individual parts of atoms, we'll model entire atoms using just their element abbreviations. We will also use spheres of different colors to represent atoms. Carbon is usually shown as a black sphere. In the last lesson, we discussed what makes atoms of different elements different from each other. But how do these different atoms come together to make all the matter around us, including us? Well, atoms of some elements are happy to exist by themselves, surrounded by other atoms of the same element. Helium gas is an example of this. A bunch of solo helium atoms floating around with a bunch of other helium atoms. But it's far more common for atoms to join together with other atoms to form molecules. Molecules are groups of 2 or more atoms bonded together. We'll learn more about bonds in chemistry, but for now, just know that a bond is a strong, attractive force that holds atoms together. Let's start with some simple examples of molecules that you are interacting with right now. What do you need to inhale to survive? If you said air, you're on the right track. Air is actually a mixture of different gas molecules, and animals need one of them in particular to survive. Oxygen. Oxygen is element number 8 on the periodic table, so we know that every oxygen atom has 8 protons. But the oxygen gas in the air you're breathing right now is actually 2 oxygen atoms bonded together to form a molecule. Oxygen atoms are more stable this way than by themselves. We can represent a molecule of oxygen gas using 2 O's, or 2 red spheres, as the atoms, with lines connecting them to represent the bonds. There are 2 lines because oxygen gas contains a double bond, but we'll learn more about that in chemistry. Both of these models show a single oxygen gas molecule. Because this molecule is made of 2 oxygen atoms, its chemical formula is O2. There's another molecule you're interacting with right now, which contains atoms of different elements. It's a gas called carbon dioxide, and your body releases it as waste every time you exhale. Based on the name carbon dioxide, can you guess which elements are included in this molecule? If you guessed carbon and oxygen, you are correct. Carbon dioxide contains 1 carbon atom and 2 oxygen atoms bonded together. Therefore, the chemical formula for this molecule is CO2. The C with no number after it implies there is just 1 carbon atom in the molecule. Because this molecule contains atoms of different elements, it is an example of a compound. Some molecules, like oxygen gas and carbon dioxide, are small, containing only two or three atoms. But some molecules are large. For example, this is a model of a caffeine molecule. It is made of 24 atoms. Recognize those black and red pieces in the model? Those are carbon and oxygen atoms. The white are hydrogen atoms, and the blue are nitrogen atoms. Molecules can be far larger still. This is a model of hemoglobin, an important protein molecule in our blood. One hemoglobin molecule is made of more than 10,000 atoms. That's a big molecule. But remember, atoms are incredibly tiny, so even a big molecule like this one is not visible to the naked eye. Notice any familiar atoms in this molecule? There are black carbon atoms, red oxygen atoms, white hydrogen atoms, and blue nitrogen atoms. These elements are very common in the molecules of life. You may have noticed that in addition to being different sizes, these different molecules have very different shapes. The shape of a molecule is very important in determining how it behaves. Structure determines function in living things, even at the molecular level. We will learn more about the importance of molecule shape in coming lessons. Okay, so living things are made of atoms, which are bonded together into lots of different molecules. But that still doesn't explain why I don't look like the food I eat, which is also made of molecules. Something must happen to the molecules in the food we eat to turn them into different molecules, which make up our bodies. And that something is chemical reactions. In a chemical reaction, bonds between atoms break, new bonds form, or both. The molecules that exist before the chemical reaction are different from the molecules which exist after the reaction. Let's look at a simple example of a chemical reaction. Remember this molecule? That's right, it's oxygen gas. Let's imagine that this molecule of oxygen gas comes in contact with another molecule. This is hydrogen gas, H2. Like oxygen, atoms of hydrogen are more stable when they're bonded in pairs. But it turns out there is an even more stable way for these atoms to bond when they come together. It requires a second molecule of hydrogen gas. So we'll put a 2 in front of the formula to represent the two molecules of hydrogen gas. All three of these molecules are the reactants, since they exist before the reaction takes place. Since they've come together and will react, we'll place a plus sign between them and an arrow after them. So, what do these molecules become? What is the chemical formula for this new molecule? Well, each molecule contains two hydrogen atoms and one oxygen atom, so the formula is H2O. Any idea what our common name for this molecule is? That's right! This is our good friend, water. And because the reaction produced two water molecules, we'll put a 2 in front of H2O. The two water molecules are the products of this chemical reaction. The molecules changed during the reaction, but did the atoms? Let's check. How many hydrogen atoms did we start with? We started with two hydrogen gas molecules, each with two hydrogen atoms. So 4 hydrogen atoms total. And we started with one oxygen gas molecule containing 2 oxygen atoms. Now let's check the products. How many hydrogen atoms do we have? 4 total. And oxygen? Still 2. The number of atoms of each element did not change. They just got rearranged. Chemical reactions are similar to Legos in that way. You can take the pieces apart and put them together into something different, but the pieces themselves don't change. And you have the same total number of Legos before and after. So, while molecules do change during chemical reactions, the identities of the atoms themselves do not. Only nuclear reactions and radioactive decay can turn an atom of one element into another. That would be like changing a purple Lego into a yellow Lego. Weird. And that's another topic for another day. Life processes are driven by chemical reactions, not nuclear ones. Many chemical reactions are occurring in your body right now to keep you alive. Some of these reactions rearrange the molecules in the food that you eat into new molecules, which form the bone, skin, and blood and other materials of your body. So while the atoms in this apple are still existing inside of me, the molecules in the apple are being changed into new molecules as I speak. Okay, the molecules in the food we eat undergo chemical reactions to become the molecules which make up our bodies. But can you think of anything else we get from our food besides mass? How would you feel if you didn't eat for a few days? Definitely hungry, but you would start to feel weak too. That's because chemical reactions involving our food provide us with energy. Energy itself is not matter, but it can be released when the atoms that make up matter, including our food, undergo chemical reactions. When our bodies break food molecules apart and form new bonds, energy is released for us to use for life processes like breathing, healing, and thinking. And of course, more chewing. We can tell how much energy can be released from a serving of food by reading or looking up the number of calories. The food with the label shown here contains 250 calories per cup, and an apple contains about 95 calories of energy. Sometimes chemical reactions release energy like the reactions that break down our food, but other reactions absorb energy like the reactions which occur in plants during photosynthesis. Apple trees absorb energy from the sun to create their own food, which they use to power all of their life processes, including apple production. Let's return to our original question. Why don't we look like the food we eat? Because chemical reactions in our bodies turn food molecules into new molecules. Life would not be possible without the chemical reactions which rearrange atoms, absorb energy, and release energy in living things. We now know that molecules are groups of two or more atoms bonded together. That in a chemical reaction, bonds between atoms break, new bonds form, or both. And that chemical reactions may release or absorb energy. Next time, we'll take a closer look at a very important molecule which is necessary for life to survive. Any ideas what it might be? Until then, remember, biology is more than just science. It's the way of life. Hey, hey.